First, giving honor to God, who is the author and perfecter of my faith, I greet you once again with joy and with love that comes from knowing our risen Savior, Jesus Christ. I just thank everyone that has assisted me in leading worship today. I give God glory and praise for you. The meditation for today's worship comes to us from the book of Revelation, chapter 1, verses 4 through 8. And I'd just like to share with you this scripture once again. Grace and peace to you from him who is and was and who is to come, from the seven spirits before his throne, and from Jesus Christ, who is the faithful witness, the firstborn from the dead, and the ruler of the kings of the earth. To him who loves us and has freed us of our sins by his blood and has made us to be a kingdom and priest to serve him, God and Father. To him be glory and power forever and ever. Amen. Look. Look, beloved. He comes in the clouds, and every eye will see him. Even those who pierce him, and all the people of earth will mourn because of him. So shall it be. Amen. The Lord said, I am the Alpha and the Omega, saith the Lord, who is and who was and who is to come, the Almighty. The word of God for the people of God, praise be to God. The reign of love. Let us look to the Lord. Most gracious Lord, we come now. Humbly come before you, Lord. Take me deep down in your treasures and lead me there. Bring forth your spirit with all power and might, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Bring forth your word with love and with power to quicken our bodies, to break the chains that bind us, to heal us. Your word, Lord. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, Lord. You are my rock and my redeemer. And the people of God do say, amen. Amen, amen, and amen. Reign of love. For 31 years, the city of Philadelphia was blessed with a woman whose reign of love fed millions. She was from a small Appalachian town called Narrows, where the image of poverty was etched in her memory. In Philadelphia, she fought hard to end hunger, and she was known as a giant in the field. She was said to have been the bedrock of the food system of Philadelphia. This same woman managed 25 employees and over 2,000 volunteers monthly. During the growing season, her reign of love increased as her labor increased. For you see, this same woman planned, managed, and operated an urban farm next door to the shared food program warehouse she managed on Huntington Park. This warrior, whose reign of love over the city of Philadelphia was well known and highly respected in the Department of Agriculture. The department even designated her to be an individual that they would use and work with to coordinate the feeding of hundreds of thousands of people if an emergency occurred in our area, like the Katrina. Who is this woman? Who was this woman? She was Stephen Ann Wine. She was the executive director of the shared food program. She was a layperson called into great ministry for the Lord. In large and small ways, Stephen Ann, like each of us today, you and I are called into ministry for the Lord. If we pause right now and just take a few seconds to reflect. You too will see that your ministry is a rain of love. It touches so many lives on behalf of the Lord. Well, the work that we do in our reign of love, it does impact. It does make a difference. But our work is not everlasting. There will come a time, just like in Stephen Ann Lyne's time, maybe we retire, and our reign of love will cease. The reign of love that we engage in is temporary. It's true that we help individuals during difficult times. It's true that we may help them through physical hardship, emotional pain, financial challenges. In our ministry of love, in our text, we discover that the Apostle John is testifying about a reign of love that is everlasting. This reign of love that he speaks of is unique. We have never experienced such power, such love. Yes, it is true that in various lay ministries, like trustees and the music ministry, the food pantry and camp ministry and outreach ministry, even in the owl ministry, we have experienced God's love through the exchange of our gifts and talents to help those through difficult times, like the loss of a job or a house burning down or the loss of a loved one, or while we are together experiencing an economic recession. The reign of love. Our participation in the reign of love can play out when individuals are going through a season of illness. We pray for them. We bring over covered dishes. We even help with household chores in our reign of love. But yet, this reign of love that we participate in is not everlasting. It's not enduring. Where is there a reign of love that is unchanging, this all-inclusive, this forever enduring? The reign of love that is eternal is the reign of love that comes from God. How can we experience God's reign of love? We experience the reign of love first by reading the Bible. When we open up the Bible, the Word of God becomes alive for us, in our minds and in our hearts. When we read the Bible, we are able to hear from the Lord instructions on how we are to live our lives. When we open up the Word of God, we also come to know and understand that God's reign is never changing. The Bible tells us in Numbers 23, verse 9, that God is not like humans, that he should lie. No, our God, he does not change. He does not speak. He does not speak and not keep his word. His promises are true and will be fulfilled. In Lamentations 5 and 9, the word tells us, you, Lord, rule forever. Your throne is from generation to generation. Even reminded in Psalms 9, verses 7 through 12, that the Lord abides forever. He has established his throne for judgment, and he will judge the world in righteousness. He will execute judgment for the people with equality. The Lord also will be a stronghold for the oppressed, a stronghold in times of trouble for all. And those who know your name, the Lord, can put their trust in him. So, beloved, how can we, you and I, experience the We experience the reign of God by reading His Word. We experience the reign of God by embracing His grace. In God's Word, He instructs us how to live our lives, and when we follow these instructions, we receive grace and receive peace. Peace for our hearts and peace for our minds when we follow the Word of God. The Bible tells us in Psalms 139, verse 13 and 14, "For you created my innermost being. You knitted me together in my mother's womb. I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made." It is God's word that reveals to us His great love for us. It is in His word that we are able to experience His reign. But more intimately, we experience the reign of God's love when we embrace Jesus Christ. It is Christ who is the witness to each and every person in all of nature of who God is and what He has done for each of us. It is Jesus Christ who came from heaven to be the example for us of how to live in community with one another and how to worship the living God. We can experience the reign of God's love when we accept Christ as our personal Savior. When we accept Christ as our personal Savior, it is in this acceptance, in this place of humility and repentance, that our sins are washed away, that the stain of our guilt and shame is eliminated, and we are made right in the presence of God. We are cleansed, we are justified and sanctified by the shed blood of Jesus. It is in this place that we experience the reign of God through Christ that is everlasting and eternal. The Bible reminds us in Romans chapter 5, verse 8, that God shows His love for us in that while we were sinners, Christ died for us. Isn't that marvelous? Isn't that wonderful? That when we were in a state of disobedience, when we were far off from doing the will of the Lord, Jesus said, "I'm worthy, you're worthy, they're worthy." And He showered upon us a rain of love that was all-inclusive. How can we experience the rain of love that is everlasting, all-inclusive? We experience this rain of love through the Holy Spirit. It is the Holy Spirit, the third person of the Trinity, that will reveal all truth to us. It is the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. It is the Holy Spirit that shows us each and every day a rain of love. How much God loves us. It is the Holy Spirit when we are worried and we question and we don't know where to go and what to do. It is the Holy Spirit that we receive at the time of our baptism that quickens inside of our bodies and comforts us. It is the Holy Spirit that will speak truth to us and say, "Don't do that, do this." It is the Holy Spirit that will convict us, that will say to us, "Forgive them, as God has forgiven you." It is the Holy Spirit that will speak to us and say to us, "Go into your closet where you hold all of your treasures and share what God has given you with those that are in need." All that God has given us, the Bible tells us, every perfect gift comes from above. We are only stewards
of that which God has entrusted to our care. How do we experience the reign of love? It's not the kind of love that human beings engage in. It's not a philo love, a friendship love. It's only temporary, based on situations and time. Oh, beloved, it is not even that eros love, that romantic love that's between a man and a woman. No, it's not that. That goes up and down, it's warm and it's hot and it's cold. Not like that. Oh, my goodness. We're talking about a reign of love that is everlasting. It never dies. It doesn't cease. It loves you when you're good and it loves you when you're not. It loves you when you're gorgeous and it loves you when you're not. We're talking about the agape love. That is the love we're speaking of. The love that flows through the Trinity, that goes between God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. If you are seeking this day an everlasting, all-abiding, all-inclusive kind of love, we offer you the reign of love that comes from the eternal God. This day, God is here. He is here for each and every one of us. The Bible says there is nothing, there is no one, there is no situation, that no action that we have engaged in or failed to do. If we repent of our sins and say to the Lord, God, as long as we have breath in our bodies, we may be in the hospital or at home and barely able to breathe, but God is with us. And we can say in our mind, Lord, have mercy. Please forgive me. In that moment, the all-inclusive reign of love of God swoops down and washes us clean and welcomes us in. This is the love we all seek. This is the love God invites us to abide in. This is the love God beckons us as his disciples to proclaim and to share. This is the love. The everlasting, all-inclusive reign of love of God that he invites us as his disciples to walk in each day and to humble ourselves before him and to give what the Spirit has given us through our gifts and our talents to one another. Whether we like the person in the moment or not, if the Spirit touches your heart, be obedient and do as the Spirit says. The Bible says obedience is better than sacrifice. Whatever you give for the Lord, he will give it back to you double. This reign of love, God speaks to us today in Revelation. This is the last Sunday of the Christian year. Next week we will begin Advent, a time of repentance, of reflection, of great anticipation, of longing for the birth of Christ. Let us today embrace God's reign. Not a reign that goes with people that we elect that are imperfect. Not a reign of kings, of husbands and wives. Not a reign of a boss or a corporation. Not even a reign of a country in power. All of these things and individuals are temporary. It is only God who is
give you an abundant life, who desire